Yeah, come on in. Hello.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. tonight, because it was Ken's music that actually was the first germ of inspiration for making this instrument, the quarter tone extended clarinet. And I wanted to kind of talk a little bit about this, because if you're here tonight, it's because you have more than passing interest in these kinds of things. And so, for anyone on the stream who is not really, really familiar with either the clarinet or with quarter tones for that matter, I'm going to talk in a little bit more detail about that. Normally, the clarinet can play these notes between the notes, the quarter notes, quarter tones, fine in a lot of the registers, but there's some parts of the instrument that just simply can't do that because of the way that the fingerings work. And Ken had written me a piece a number of years ago that was for the clarinet with a wind ensemble in a concerto kind of scenario. And he had conceptualized it with a lot of these quarter tones, including some of them at the very bottom of the instrument. And I was looking through the first parts he'd given to me, and I said, I can't play those lowest notes. And he said, but wouldn't it be cool? And I keep on, every time I talk about this story, I remembered that exact quote so vividly, because I thought, wouldn't that be cool? And it got me to thinking, there's so many limitations that we have as a performer asking a composer to write for the instrument, and I have to say, well, this part doesn't work great. If you're writing quarter tones, watch out in the middle of the staff, there's some of those notes that aren't playable or really hard to get to. And I thought, what kind of music would composers write if I could just say, we're good, do the things that you want? And so that's what made this instrument possible. And I had a wonderful team of craftspeople in Copenhagen, Denmark, put this instrument together for me. And the small TLDR version is, there are five extra tone holes that don't normally exist on the clarinet. And there are also two new keys, this one here and this one here, that depending on what other notes I have down, will make these new quarter tones possible. So in some of these instances where we had to do some really funky things with our thumb and stuff like this to try to make these things happen, now we have dedicated tone holes just for these quarter tones. And it makes me really, really happy that I can now play that low F quarter sharp, which was the note in Ken's concerto that, that in fact, really is very cool. And so, and that's what we're doing tonight. This is actually the first full concert length performance with the quarter tone extended clarinet. Only the second time I've ever played it for anybody in public. And so, you're all getting to hear history being made. So, we have three more pieces on this program, and I want to talk just a little bit about each one of these. These were all pieces that I commissioned for this specific instrument. Met with the composers, showed each one what this could do, and then just said, what would you write? What would you make with this? And I've specifically chosen these pieces because they are all quite contrasting in the way that the composers have decided to use the instrument and this material. So, this next piece by Forrest Pierce is called Essay on Aching. And I just want to read the program note that he gives at the beginning of this, because it really is evocative of what he's written here. How do we reconcile the natural with the uncomfortable, suffering with acceptance, the fruiting body of the mushroom with the miles of underground mycelia, the wounds of childhood with their echoes and the personality of the adult? The ache of a human being is in a virus spread through relationship and community, in the individuation of a child that once was inseparable from the mother, in the longing of the soul for connection with the divine. It's in the mysterious yet commonplace and natural betrayal of DNA that leads to metastasis and dire illness. It's in the deadly poison that will heal it and cause it to come back in a different form years later. It is in the discovery that new holes, new wires, new techniques of finger and synapses of brain may transform a closed tube into a vastly richer set of openings and call new music into being from those connections. So the thing that I find most fascinating about Forrest Pierce writing for this instrument is that his music is absolutely diatonic. He loves the diatonic world. And so when I asked him to write a piece for a quarter tone instrument, I wasn't sure exactly what he would come up with. And what we end up with is actually a set of different worlds starting from some of these diatonic places, but with quarter tone transpositions all throughout. And so this kind of aching, this kind of yearning that he's writing about in this program note, I think really comes through in the way that he's written with these strains that he's put into the quarter tone clarinet. So, essay on aching.
Thank you.
more of the moisture out of this while I talk more about some of these collaborations. This next piece, the composer's name is Jesse Cox, and he is a composer who was born in Switzerland, lives in New York. He's a jazz drummer. His parents are from Trinidad and Tobago, and so he has several different influences that he brings into his music. And when I met with him, he talked about his interest specifically in the Sun Ra Orchestra and in the music of Marshall Allen, who had led that group for a number of years after the Sun Ra was no longer with us. And so much of Jesse's music centers on Afrofuturism and the ideas of a sort of imagined future in which technology is a liberating force for the African diaspora. And this particular piece, Light Dots on a Deep Space Image, is something that continues that idea and is also evocative of the music of Marshall Allen. And so the poetry that is contained in here is something that Jesse has written and is something that you want to hear in the context of this idea of what the future can bring for people who look like him. So, here we go. That's all I'm going to say about this before I go on. Okay. Light thoughts on a deep space image. Tiny dot. sense. Sense more powerful than hope. More than. Courage. For some. Better.
space image.
Before I get to my last piece here, there's a few people I want to make sure to thank you. I want to thank Brendan for all the work he's been doing with all the video, and also Hallie. They've been here all afternoon as well as tonight, so very much appreciate that. Also want to thank Ed Campione and SynMap for having me here, and David Milne and the School of Music at Cal for this, and especially Ken Ueno for bringing me out here and writing not only this piece, but all the music that inspired this whole thing. And so, this last piece on the program today by Kristen Soriano Broberg, she's very much interested in spectral music. And her approach to this instrument was one of wanting to use the quarter tone possibilities to more accurately reflect these elements of the overtones in the spectrum go through. And so as such, she's written something that is very much integral to ideas of proportion and the Fibonacci sequence and all of these kinds of things that composers love to talk about. And I'm hoping that the main effect will be something where you'll feel and hear all of these things. There's a few things I do want to point out. She will get through these elements of the spectrum and then express it in these sweeps of the full spectrum that happen periodically throughout this piece. And she's also taken this idea of pacing and has, as other composers have done before, has this huge climactic event that happens exactly at this golden mean ratio through the piece. And so when you hear that, then hopefully you know right where we are in the piece. And so and she's called this piece Aura. I think that is as much of an evocative title about the sort of the umbra and penumbra of the sounds as anything. And so and what I especially enjoy now that I've had a chance to play all these pieces is experiencing the whole thing that I had hoped to have happen, which was that each composer has taken what this instrument can do and really done very different things with them. And as of right now, I have probably six more pieces that are right in the process of completion, and I'll be performing them more. And I'm just mostly excited to see what exactly happens when suddenly composers can write all these quarter tone things for the clarinet. So stay tuned, there'll be more out there. Anyone who's interested in this, wants to look at this, you know, like see what's going on, please feel free to come up afterwards. I'm happy to show you and talk and answer any questions about this thing as well, because well, it's the only one right now. So, all right, well, thanks so much for coming out, and we'll be hearing Kristen Soriano Broberg's Aura. Thank you.
house without the